Solve by factoring. Remember to put the answers in increasing order. So 2x squared minus 13x plus 20 equals 0. So factor by grouping situation because of this 2 in front of the x squared. So the first step is I'm going to multiply the 2 times the 20, and that's going to make 40. And then I need to find the factors of 40 that add to negative 13. Now notice here there's a positive sign, and you have a negative sign in the middle. So this means you have two negatives that multiply to make the positive. So my factors both have to have the negative sign. So possible factors of negative 40, there's negative 1 and negative 40, negative 2, negative 20, negative 4, and then negative 10, negative 5, negative 8. Well, that one works because negative 5 plus negative 8 is negative 13. So now I can rewrite the polynomial. 2x squared minus 5x minus 8x plus 20 equals 0. Take out what's in common with the first two terms is simply an x. And x times what makes 2x squared? That's 2x. X times what makes negative 5x? That's negative 5. And then minus here, so I'm going to put the minus out in front. What's in common with the 8x and the 20? Looks like it's just a 4. So negative 4 times what makes negative 8x? That's a positive 2x. Negative 4 times what makes positive 20? That's negative 5 equals 0. 2x minus 5, 2x minus 5 again. That means you can group them together. So it's going to be x minus 4, parentheses, and then times 2x minus 5. And that still equals 0. So now it's factored, we're going to go ahead and solve. Zero product property, x minus 4 equals 0, and 2x minus 5 equals 0. Add 4 to both sides, so you get x equals 4. Add 5 to both sides, 2x equals 5, and then divide by 2, x equals 5 halves. So the two answers, in increasing order, let's see, 4 is bigger than 5 halves, so I'm going to have x equals 5 halves, comma 4. Okay, and those are your answers.